This was a night of terror. What was originally an industrial dispute became the first major test of the newly elected Labour Front government. The strike by workers of the Hockley Amalgamated Bus Company in 1955 had turned into a bloody riot. April 18th, 1955. At the Hockley bus depot in Alexandra Road, about 300 bus workers refused to work for 2 hours. One of them, Quek Sin Liang, recalls why. These were members of the leftist Singapore Bus Workers Union. The company did not approve of them, so it assigned more jobs to non-union workers. The daily rate union members felt they were discriminated against and threatened to strike again if the situation did not improve. 24th April 1955, a week later, the Hockley bus workers were again on strike. At 5:45 a.m., six of them, all daily rated and members of the union, were told there was no work for them. In a show of support, all the others decided to stop work. The company sacked 229 of them. The strike continued for more than 24 hours. The company offered to reinstate those who were willing to admit they were in the wrong, but this was rejected by the workers. They demanded instead that all of them be reinstated unconditionally. Picketing outside the depot, the strikers sang and danced to keep their spirits high. And when the company decided to put some buses on the roads, they tried to stop them. Then another group, students from the Chinese secondary schools, turned up in large numbers to show their support for the strikers.
The students during that day were very anti-British, and because of the communist influence, I think naturally they have links with the workers' unions. But there are many things the workers might not be able to do. They have their limitations set, like they are educationally backward. So the communists will of course use the students, I mean, as the agents, so-called to educate the people. So we will mobilize the students to go there to educate the workers in various ways, like teaching them to sing songs, and also folk dancing. And through these activities also, we will sustain their spirit.
27th April 1955. By this time, the strikers were camping outside the depot. At 6 a.m., the police was called in to help clear the way for the buses to run. In the clashes that followed, 15 strikers and several policemen were injured. Members of the Singapore Bus Workers Union working in the other bus companies were infuriated. They stopped work for 4 hours that day to protest against what they called police bullying. They felt that the Labour Front government had treated the Hockley strikers unfairly. Chief Minister David Marshall decided to set up a commission to look into the Hockley dispute. Over the next week, the commission held its inquiry. It made several recommendations on how to resolve the dispute, but still the disputing parties could not agree with each other. The workers continued to picket outside the depot, and the students brought food and money to them. They danced and sang songs like Unity in Strength. The police moved in to disperse them.
The British said to me, we want you to request, this is the governor, I want you to request me to order British troops to fire on rioters. I said, me? Order British troops to fire on my own people? I said, look, you've got to be patient with them. The people are like sick children. They're being misled. You've got to be patient. You've got to explain. You've got to make them understand. To have acted otherwise would have meant not only a large number of deaths, but also the total alienation of the people from the process of democratic government, and they are throwing them back into the last resort, which is a communist revolution.
But patience could not stop the communists from further instigating the rioters. With each day, the tension increased. By now, the various parties had become impatient with each other. There seemed to be no solution. 12th May 1955, about 3 weeks later, things finally came to a head and force had to be used. Trouble began soon after Chinese students arrived at the Hockley depot in 20 lorries at 2:15 p.m. Clashes with the police took place and soon a violent drama unfolded. Students used stones, bottles and bricks against the police. In the midst of confusion and chaos, vehicles were overturned and burned, and many people injured. Police detective Yun Yaoping suffered critical injuries when rioters set fire to his car and lost his life. The violence did not end until early the next morning. This was the day later known as Black Thursday. 14th May 1955. There was an uneasy calm at the funeral of 16-year-old Chong Lon Chong. He suffered a gunshot wound on the night of the riots and was paraded around town as evidence of police brutality. By the time he was sent to the hospital, it was too late. On the same day, Marshall announced the end of the Hockley bus dispute. The bus workers were reinstated. They had won their case. However, this did not stop workers of other companies from expressing their anger at the government. A series of strikes took place. Chinese school students, they were held partly responsible for the bloodshed. Their schools were closed, and this led to an outbreak of student agitation. This was a difficult time for the Labour Front government. David Marshall, in particular, was criticised by the British for being weak in his handling of the Hockley riots. To them, it showed that Singapore was not yet ready to govern herself, and this greatly hindered our quest for independence. It was only 3 years later we were able to negotiate successfully for self-rule.